I welcome all of you on this platform of Adda 247 for this ultimate complete package for IBPS RRB prelims. This session, I must tell you, is completely in English. We are dedicating this session, the last session of the day, for those candidates who are having difficulties in taking those sessions in Hindi. The first three sessions of the day, that would be completely in Hindi or bilingual mode. Teachers will take the classes in both these languages, and the last session will be completely in English. For those students who are coming from down south or from northeastern part of our country and who are having any kind of trouble in understanding the language, so what we are thinking, we have dedicated this entire session completely in English. Okay, fine. Now I welcome all for this class, for this session. I hope you people are joining till the time we are taking some more candidates for this session. First of all, I would like to know whether you people are aware of the importance of the second half of the year. Why the second half of the year from June to December is very important for banking aspirants? Because in the second half of the year, we are having so many vacancies coming out in this sector. Talking about clerical cadre exams and PO cadre exams, the first one to go is IBPS RRB, PO and clerk both. And after that, we'll have IBPS PO and clerk. And then comes the IT officer. Then after that, we'll have SBI and then insurance examinations for ADO post, for AAO post and AO post as well. Okay, fine. Now let's start with this session. What is the importance of this session? Why we are taking this session? Let me tell you first. This session would be completely dedicated to this ultimate complete package of Adda 247 would be completely dedicated to IBPS RRB prelims examination. We are taking this session for prelims examination so that you can qualify for mains, and then we'll cover the mains portion as well. We'll guide you for the mains portion as well. Okay, so now in prelim portion, we have two different subjects, maths and reasoning, as we all know. Maths and reasoning. How many questions of maths we are going to have? 40 questions of maths as well as 40 questions in reasoning. Okay, and the time devoted would be 45 minutes. So in 45 minutes, you have to attempt those 80 questions. And how this is challenging and how that would become a challenging session for us, because here the speed must be very high. The accuracy must be there. If you are targeting only speed and you're not providing attention to your accuracy, then also you are going to lose your mark. So within that stipulated time, if you have to attempt those 80 questions, so that is again in a challenge in a different way. Fine. So maintaining your accuracy, maintaining your speed, you have to score marks, as we all know that. But we have one advantage. Advantage will go like here. The paper won't be as tough, because in 45 minutes, if a candidate is attempting those 80 questions, and so, that means what? He's getting less than 1 minute for one question. So within 60 seconds or in less than 60 seconds, if one has to attempt one question at least, then automatically or obviously we can conclude that the difficulty level won't be very high. So this I'm taking as an advantage. Okay, yes, we'll cover PO level as well as clerical level, but since it's for the pre-level examination, it's not for the mains level examination. We'll cover all the basics. We'll take you to the average level question, up to the average level questions, because above average is not required for this session. We'll take another session where we'll cover all the questions which are above average, which are tough, which requires some thinking, which requires some time also. If I want to provide those questions here in this session, that is not at all required. Okay, yes, puzzles will take more time, but yes, those puzzles will be you can, if you want to attempt those puzzles, you can within time, you can do that, because there won't be any twist and turn. Those puzzles will be simple and straightforward puzzles. Okay, so those candidates who are having good amount of practice In puzzles, they can easily attempt questions within time. So you don't have to worry about that. For practicing puzzles, you have so many online sources. You have so many websites. You can practice puzzles. You can go through our Adda 24/7 channel. We have so many sessions dedicated to puzzles, basic puzzles, the advanced puzzles, the average puzzles. Okay. Now let's start the class. Maths and reasoning. Now here we are for reasoning section. Now I won't explain the entire reasoning session today because we'll take one session at a time. So today's session will be completely dedicated to inequality. What we are trying to do, we are going to take the first topic, that is inequality. Now I'll explain why I'm taking this chapter as the first unit, because from inequality we'll have 3 to 5 questions for sure. Those 3 to 5 questions for sure, and these 3 to 5 questions can be attempted within time. Within time you can attempt these questions. Accuracy is there. You can score whatever number of questions are there. You can score 100% marks from this chapter. Okay, so in a way that is easy, but yes, we do have so many twists and turns in inequality as well. We'll discuss each and everything in detail in today's class. Okay, first of all, why we are taking inequality, let me explain this to you. All the qualities of this chapter is visible to you people. 3 to 5 questions, as I explained, you have 3 to 5 questions in every examination. It's easy to score within time. Accuracy you can maintain. And then here we'll cover all the types of questions, previous year papers, and then latest pattern questions. Okay, so we'll cover each and everything in detail. Now don't worry about all the things. Fine. Now first of all, let me explain the term inequality. From where this term is coming, what does this term inequality means? Okay, now whenever we are comparing elements which are not equal, okay, when you are comparing those elements which are not equal, then in that case this term comes into picture. When we are comparing those elements which are equal, fine, then there is no need to have this term or this chapter inequality. So inequality comes into picture when we are comparing elements which are not equal. Okay, now this is a basic idea of inequality. Fine, because in our day-to-day life also most of the time we have this scenario of comparison. So when we talk about comparison means what? We have two different elements or more than two different elements where the things are not same, where the qualities are not same, and then in that case we comes along with this term inequality. Okay, now first thing you should know and everyone should know is the symbols of inequality. How many symbols of inequality we have? Okay, so talking about the number of symbols in inequality, we are having 5 different symbols of inequality. I'll explain them one by one. Those are the symbols. This is greater than, everyone knows that. This is greater than or equal to, fine. And those who are asking for sessions in Hindi, those sessions will be there in the first three. The first three sessions would be dedicated to Hindi. Early morning 7 to 10, then we have 12 to 3, then we have 4 to 7 p.m. Okay, so those three sessions are completely in Hindi. This session is dedicated to English. Okay, now greater than, the first sign of inequality is greater than, the second is greater than or equal to, the third sign is less than, fourth sign is less than or equal to, and now fifth sign. You may have seen this symbol written in this chapter. You may have seen about this symbol written all over the place, but what is the name of our topic? Inequality. And what does this mean? Equal to. Now how can equal to sign a symbol of inequality. So I must tell you this thing first of all, equal to sign is not the symbol of inequality. So then why we are using this symbol in our topic? Just to confuse you, just to engage you in different scenarios. Okay, so now equal to, we should not consider this sign as the sign of inequality. Fine. Now instead of equal to, what we are going to do, whenever you will come across equal to, what you have to do, you have to replace that equal to sign with a comma sign. This is a comma sign. Let me cover this up, write this up in a bracket. You have to replace equal to with a comma sign whenever we are having or whenever we are seeing equal to in the statement. In all these statements, replace equal to with a comma sign. Okay. Now this is the bottom line. What I'm trying to tell you. Why? That clearly means we are not considering equal to as a sign of inequality. In other words, suppose this is my statement. Okay. Now, whenever we are seeing this statement, what we have to do, we have to replace this statement. A is greater than or equal to B, B is greater than or equal to C, and C comma D. What I'm doing, see this. We are replacing equal to sign with a comma sign. So I'm not using equal to here. We are using comma. And then we can continue like this. So this statement can be replaced with this one. What I have done, I have replaced equal to sign with a comma sign. So that was the rule I was telling you people, that whenever we are having equal to sign in this statement, we have to replace equal to sign with a comma sign. Okay. Why we have to do that, I'll tell you later on. Now, then what is the fifth symbol? These are the four symbols: greater than or equal to, less than or equal to. Apart from these four, we have this symbol which is saying not equal to. This is not equal to. And not equal to means, suppose I'm saying A is not equal to B. That means two different things. That means A is greater than B or A is less than B. Fine. So these are the five symbols of inequality: greater than equal to, less than equal to, or not equal to. Fine. Now, the point is, we have some different representation of these symbols as well. Now I'll come across with all the different representations. Now I will request everyone simultaneously while attending this session, you can write it down, all the slides which I am providing you one by one. So this is our first slide. Whatever we have discussed in this slide, you can keep on writing on a paper wherever you are, and then so that we can move in a proper way. Fine. So now I'll tell you another way of writing those symbols. Fine. Let me give you some examples. Nowadays, what they are doing in the examination, they are giving you some different ways. They are providing you some different symbols to replace them. For example, this is less than. Okay. Now, if I'll cut this less than, then what you'll read this as? A is not less than B. We can read out this statement as A is not less than B. Fine. Now, if A is not equal to B, that clearly means A is greater than or equal to B. If A is not less than B, not less than means either A is greater than or equal to. So not less than can be represented in this format. So these two symbols are same. Can I say that not less than is equal to greater than or equal to? Now, if I'm saying not less than equal to, if I'm telling you A is not less than or equal to B. So if A is not less than B, A is not equal to B, that clearly means what? A is greater than B. Getting my point? So now not less than or equal to can be written in the form of greater than. Okay. Now here we can represent less than or equal to in the form of not greater than, and here we can represent this in the form of not greater than or equal to. Okay. Done. So these are the different representations of these symbols. Okay, so there are five symbols, and these five symbols can be represented in this format. The upper line is providing you the direct representation. The lower line is giving you the indirect or the different representation of those symbols. Okay, now moving on. To understand this topic, first of all, what we need to do, we need to understand one basic small concept of line of control. To make things very easy, we have a hypothetical concept of line of control. Okay, now first of all, you need to understand what is line of control. Okay, line of control means whenever two different symbols of inequalities are having their faces together in one direction. See this. These two symbols are closing their faces together in one direction. These two symbols are opening their faces together in one direction. Getting my point? Here in the first case, these two symbols, they are closing their faces in one direction. These two are opening their faces in one direction. So whenever we are encountering these situation in our statement, we need to draw a line of control between these two consecutive symbols. Okay, that means here we'll have a situation of line of control. The situation of line of control can also arise in this format. It doesn't matter whether we are having equal to sign attached with those symbols or not. Suppose you are saying, can we have a line of control between these two symbols? Yes, we can have a line of control between these two symbols. Why we can have a line of control? Because see, here in those two consecutive symbols, the faces of those symbols are getting opened together in one direction. Okay. Now, those candidates who are telling me to talk in Hindi, this session is completely dedicated to English medium candidates. So I'll request them to follow the first three sessions of the day. If you're not getting anything, then please do follow the first three sessions of the day. This session would be completely in English. Okay, fine. Now, what is the meaning of line of control? You know how we are going to have line of control? Yes, when the faces of both these symbols are being closed, or when the faces of both these symbols are being opened together in one direction, then we are having a line of control. Okay, now, what is the role and what is the importance of this line of control? It's very simple. Suppose I'm giving you, this is my statement. Now, first question, do we have a line of control in this statement? Yes, we do have a line of control. Why do we do have a line of control? Because see, the faces of those two symbols are getting closed together in one direction. So we are having a line of control passing over B. Fine. This line of control is being passing over B. Fine. Yes, there can be multiple line of controls also. One question, Joseph. Yes, you can have so many line of controls together in one statement as well. For example, suppose I'm telling you A is greater than or equal to B. B is greater than or equal to C. C is less than D. D is less than or equal to E. Or maybe this. Suppose this is my statement. Now, first of all, you need to understand where we are having line of control. We are having line of control passing over C also. Why? Because see this, these two symbols are having their faces close together in one direction. Fine. Do we have a line of control passing over E? Yes. Why we have a line of control? Because see, the faces of these two symbols are getting opened together in one direction. So here we are having two line of control. So this is my first concept, line of control. What is a line of control? What we'll do whenever two symbols are having their faces closed together in one direction, or two symbols are having their faces opened together in one direction, then in that situation we'll have a line of control. Okay, now then I've given you two examples where we can draw line of control. A statement can have multiple line of controls as well, depending on the statement. Okay, Now, here in the first example, suppose I have taken the first example. Here in this example, A is greater than B. I am breaking this down. See, then we'll have the importance, then we'll understand the importance of line of control. Okay, now here A is greater than B. In the same statement, C is also greater than B. Here in this statement, A is greater than B and C is also greater than B. Fine. Now, if I ask you to compare, can we compare A and C? Now, this is my question. Can we compare A and C? No. It's very simple. If both A and C are greater than B, then how can you tell which one out of A and C is greater to whom? So here between A and C, there is no relation. We can't compare. No, no is the answer. So how can we say this? There is no relation. There is no relation between A and C. Getting my point? So we can conclude that whenever elements are coming from different sides of LOC, then they don't have any relation. Understand my point, okay? What we can conclude that when elements are coming from different sides of LOC, then they don't have any relation. This can be concluded easily with our discussion. Okay? We can't compare A and C. So can we say that A and C, these are coming from different sides of line of control? A is from the left side, C is from the right side. So there is no relation. We can't compare A with C. Why? Because both are greater than B. Both A and C are greater than B, but we don't have any information regarding A and C. Out of A, which one is A and C, which one is greater and which one is smaller, we don't have any idea. So we can say that there is no relation. Okay. So this is the importance of line of control. Fine. Now we have two different concepts to cover the entire topic. If we want to cover inequality from every examination's point of view. Okay. Yes, in short, we can say that it's a blocked condition. Yes, this is applicable everywhere. Fine. Now, this entire topic would be divided into two different concepts. Line of control is not the concept. Line of control is a term which I simply wanted to explain just to make our task easier for the exam. Okay. Because we have a target of speed also. We have to maintain our speed in the examination hall also. Fine. So line of control, we know that now. When two symbols are having their faces closed, or when two symbols are having their faces opened, then we have a situation of line of control. And what we have concluded that whenever we are comparing, whenever elements are coming from different sides of LOC, then they don't have any relation. For example, here A and C are coming from different sides. That means A and C don't have any relation. Yes, we can say that A and C don't have any relation. Fine. Now, I'll be moving on to concept number one. First of all, the first concept. Keep on writing all the discussion, all the things which we are taking in the class, okay? You people can't see others comment. You people can only comment whatever you have doubt. Fine. Now, concept number one. Concept number one would be applied whenever we are comparing elements from different sides of LOC. Fine. Now, in concept number one, what we are going to do, we are going to cover all the situations, all the concepts where elements are coming from different sides of LOC. Fine. Whenever we have to compare elements from different sides of LOC, then we'll apply concept number one. Okay. So first of all, let me take a situation. Let me take a statement first. Okay. In equation, separate elements are given by separating it with a comma. Nirali is having a doubt. Ki they are separating different statements with a comma sign. Yes, they are doing that. My point was, whenever we are having an equal to sign with a given in this statement, then we have to replace that equal to sign with a comma sign. Their comma doesn't mean equal to. When they are giving comma sign themselves in the statement, that doesn't mean that is equal to. Their comma means they are separating two different statements. Okay. LOC means line of control. Those who are joining the class late, please go through the previous things which we have discussed. Okay. Yes, you can replace that with a slash also, Harshita. Yes, you can replace it with a slash. We don't have any problem. No comma, it's up to you. It's simply a convention whether you want to replace that equal to sign with a comma sign or whether you want to replace that equal to sign with a slash sign. That completely your choice. That's completely up to you what you want to do. Fine. It's simply a convention. So don't get confused into convention. It's simply your habit. Yes, you can use and symbol, whatever you want to use. Simply replace equal to sign. What is my motive? My motive is to tell you to replace equal to sign from the statement, because equal to sign is not the sign of inequality. Okay, fine. And if there is no equal to, if there is no equal to sign, then we don't have any problem. I have given you an example. Okay, let me take an example again. What I wanted to say, I wanted to say this. I wanted to say this key. This is, suppose this is my statement. This statement, you can write it down in a different format. A is greater than or equal to B, comma C greater than or equal to D. This can be written in this form. That clearly means between B and C, there is no sign of inequality. Comma means equal to, and comma means there is no sign of inequality. So B and C, they are together acting as one element. Okay, fine. Now, moving on. What we are going to discuss in concept number one, when we are comparing elements from different sides of LOC. So let me take an example first. A is greater than B, greater than or equal to B, is greater than or equal to C, is greater than D, greater than or equal to E, then suppose F and G. Okay, we are talking about concept number one. This is my statement. Fine. Now, whenever you are getting this statement, the first thing you have to decide whether there is a line of control or not. Okay, whether we are having a line of control or not. So tell me, do we have a line of control here? Yes, we do have a line of control passing through. E, yes or no? Yes, we do have a line of control passing through E. Why this is a line of control? Because these two symbols, the faces of these two symbols are getting close together in one direction, one side. Fine, that is the reason why we are having a line of control situation. We don't have any other line of control situation. We don't have line of control situation here. We don't have any line of control situation there. So we don't have any line of control situation at these locations. Fine, but yes, we do have a line of control situation between D and F, and that line of control would be passing through E. Now, read out the concept number one. Whenever we are comparing elements from different sides of LOC, this concept will come into play when you have to compare elements which are coming from different sides of LOC. Fine. Now, what are the various cases? Suppose I need to compare A with F. A and F, they are coming from different sides of LOC. Suppose I need to compare B and G. B and G are coming from different sides of LOC. Suppose I need to compare D and F. Now D and F, they are coming from different sides of LOC. You can pick any element. Suppose you need to cover C and G. Now C and G, they are coming from different sides of LOC. So whenever we are comparing elements coming from different sides of LOC, then concept number one will come into picture. Okay. Now different sides means A, F, A is from the left side, F is from the right side. B and G, they are coming from different sides. D and F coming from different sides. D and G, pick any element. You can pick any two elements which are coming from different sides. And when elements are coming from different sides, then we have to apply concept number one. Now what this concept number one says? This concept number one says that I'll write down the entire statement and then we'll understand what I have written. Okay, the result is there is no relation between elements of different sides of LOC. So this is my result. I have given you the result as well. Okay. When we are comparing elements from different sides of LOC, then what is one liner result? The result is very simple. There is no relation between elements coming from different sides of LOC. Okay. Now, when there is no relation between elements coming from different sides of LOC, then for example, suppose I need to compare A and F. Example. So how can we conclude this? I'll say A and F, they are coming from different sides. Yes, you can watch that clearly in this statement. A is on the left side, F is on the right side. So they are coming from different sides. Then what is my result? There is no relation between what? Between A and F. Now, if there is no relation between A and F, how can we conclude this? We can't conclude anything. Now compare this same scenario with a practical life scenario. Suppose I'm saying there is one guy named Shitanshu, which is bigger than me. Okay. Shitanshu is bigger than me. And there is another guy, Saurabh. Saurabh is also bigger than me. So I have given you two different candidates, two different people who are bigger than me. So Shitanshu is bigger than me. Saurabh is also bigger than me. Now, if I ask you to compare who among Shitanshu and Saurabh, they are bigger, who among them is smaller. So can you compare Shitanshu with Saurabh? No, we can't compare Shitanshu with Saurabh because both are in terms of age bigger than me. So there is no relation. Now, if there is no relation in a practical life, what we can say, either Shitanshu is bigger than Saurabh, or Shitanshu is less than Saurabh or smaller than Saurabh, or both may be equal as well. If we don't have any idea or any information between Shitanshu and Saurabh, then what we can say? We can say that either Shitanshu is bigger than Saurabh or Shitanshu is smaller than Saurabh, or both can be equal as well. So here also we are going to apply the same practical scenario. What we are saying, A and F coming from different sides. That means there is no relation between A and F. And when there is no relation between A and F, can we say that either A is greater than F or A is less than F or A is equal to F? Yes, we can say that. No relation means what? All the three signs are required. Are you getting my point? When we are comparing those two elements where there is no relation, then what we can conclude? We can say that there is no relation. That means either A is greater than F or A is less than F or A can be equal to F as well. Okay. Now all the three signs are required. So that is the result of concept number one. Concept number one, when we have to apply concept number, I'm revising everything again. Be patient and listen to me very carefully. When we are comparing elements from different sides of line of control, then the result says that there is no relation between elements from different sides of LOC. Fine. When there is no relation between elements from different sides of LOC, that means all the three signs are required. No relation means all the three signs are required. And what are those three signs? Greater than, less than, and equal to. These are the three signs which are required, okay, to compare those elements where we have no relation at all. Fine. So here A and F, the same result. If you want to compare C and G, the same result. If you want to compare B and F, same result. D and G, same result. You can pick any two elements coming from different sides. The same result will take place. Okay. Now, there are different cases as well. I'll give you cases one by one. I'll pick any two elements from different sides of LOC, and then I'll give you some cases through which they kind of bluff the students. If they want to pull your leg within your examination hall, they can easily do that by giving you some proper twist and turn. And those candidates who are not able to clear their basics, they can easily fumble in those questions. Okay, now moving on. If there is no relation between elements of different sides of LOCs, let's take the first case. Now I'll show you all the cases from where they can ask the question. Case number one. Now to understand the cases, let's pick any two random element coming from two different sides. Whatever element you want to pick, you can do that. Suppose I'm taking A and G. Fine. You should not be in doubt why I'm taking A and G only. You can pick any two elements. You can pick C and F if you want to. You can pick D and G if you want to. So my choice is A and G. Suppose I'm taking A and G. Fine. Now, between A and G, suppose this is the statement which I've already written. I'm taking the same line as my statement and then I'm providing you some conclusion. A is greater than G. A is less than G. And A is equal to G. Fine. Now you have gone through the statement. Now we are coming on to conclusions. Suppose first conclusion is talking about A and G. Now what do you require? A and G. You'll say A and G are coming from different sides. And if they're coming from different sides, that means they have no relation. And if they have no relation, that means how many signs are required? Greater than is required, less than is required, and equal to is required. Okay, so all the three signs are required. No relation means three signs needed. Okay, now in the case first, A is greater than G, A is less than G, and A is equal to G. You are getting all the three requirements. Your requirement was all the three signs. They have given you all the three signs in the conclusion. So if I'm getting all the three signs in the conclusion, my answer will be either or. Yes, you can distinguish when there is one question. How can we distinguish when there are multiple LOCs? I'll explain that question again, Joseph. Don't worry. I'll take one more example where I'll have so many more than one line of control. Okay, so don't worry about that. When two consecutive signs are having their faces open towards in the same direction or their faces closed towards the same direction, then only I'm talking about two consecutive signs. Okay, fine. Now either or situation means my answer here would be either C1 or C2 or C3. You're getting my point. See what I'm telling you. A and G, different sides, no relation. No relation means three signs required. What if I've provided you all the three signs together in one? and not in one, but in case number one, we have taken three different conclusions, and those three conclusions are talking about A and G, and we are getting all the three signs of between A and G. A is greater than G, A is less than G, and A is equal to G. Now in this case, when we are getting all the three signs together, that means here we have the either or situation. So the answer would be either C1 or C2 or C3. Fine. Again, the same two elements I have considered. Fine. The same two elements. Suppose we are talking about A and G, so we are continue talking about A and G. Fine. Now, case number two. Suppose their conclusion comes like A is greater than or equal to G and A is less than G. Suppose I'm having two different conclusions in this format talking about A and G. Now, how your analysis should be done? It's very basic. A and G, they are from different sides. It's very simple to understand. Different sides means no relation. No relation means three signs are required. I'm repeating that again and again so that it can be engraved in your mind. Okay. Now A is greater than or equal to G and A is less than G. See, between A and G, are we getting all the three signs? Yes, we are getting all the three signs. A is greater than G. Your demand was three different signs. Look at your demand. You were demanding three signs. They have provided you all the three signs. See, A is greater than G, A is equal to G, and here A is less than G. So all the three signs are coming between A and G. So my demand is being completed. So here also we are having either or situation. So my answer would be either C1 or C2. This is my answer for this case. That means what? If you're demanding all the three signs between any two element and they are providing you all the three signs, then we have a situation of either or. If they are providing all the three signs in two conclusions, like in the case number two, they have provided you all the three signs in two conclusions only. So here also we are having either or situation. Okay. Now suppose in a different way, we can have either or situation also, like less than equal to and greater than. Suppose you have provided me all the three signs. A is less than G. A is equal to G. A is greater than G. So here also my answer would be either or. Okay. Now this was your second case. I hope you must have written this down. Fine. Now case number three. Now I'm taking the third case. So difference between one person is asking, what is the difference between case one and case two? And difference is very simple. You have demanded three signs. Those three signs, if they are coming in three different conclusions, this was case first. If those three signs are coming in two different conclusions only, then that is case two. Fine. How it is either or if there is no relation? No relation means either A would be greater than G or A would be less than G or A would be equal to G, because there is no other case apart from that. So if we don't have any relation between A and G, that means either A is greater or A is less or A is equal. Fine. Now we are taking the third case. Suppose A is, conclusion number one is saying A is greater than G, A is less than G. Now here also we are comparing A and G. A and G, they are from different sides. Again, I'm repeating everything so that you can be easily memorizing things. Different sides means no relation. If they are coming from different sides, that means there is no relation. And if there is no relation, that means three signs are required. Three signs are required. Now between A and G, here also we are having no relation because the statement is same. So if there is no relation between A and G, how many signs are required? Three signs are required. How many signs we are getting here? A is greater than G, A is less than G. So both the conclusions are false here. Okay, suppose they have given A is greater than G, A is equal to G. Here also both are false. Why false? Because all the three signs are not given. Suppose they are providing A is greater than or equal to G and G is less than A. Now between A and G there is no relation. No relation means all these signs are required. Fine, all these signs are required. So all the three signs are required. Now look at this case. A is greater than G, A is equal to G. A is greater than or equal to G. And here also A is greater than. Read out the line. We are not looking for the symbol. We are looking for the meaning of that line. So A is greater than or equal to G. And here also A is greater than G. So that means here also I'm not getting all the three signs. So there the answer is false. Both are false. Yes, neither nor is nothing but both are false. When we are having two conclusions and both are false, so you can say this as both are false, or you can say this as neither C1 nor C2. Okay. Third case is very simple. Those who are asking me to repeat the third case, the third case is very simple. When we are having no relation between two different elements coming from different sides, then we require all the three signs. Are we getting all the three signs here? A is greater than G, A is less than G. No. So if I'm not getting all the three signs, then both are wrong. Are we getting all the three signs? A is greater than G and A is equal to G. No. So this is also false. Here, are we getting all the three signs? Yes or no? Let me check this. A is greater than G, A is equal to G, and the third one is also saying A is greater than G. Here also both are false because we are not getting all the three signs. I hope now things would be much clearer to you. Now I'm taking the next case. Case number four. Now in case number four, suppose I am taking the first conclusion as A equal to G. Now, like I told you earlier in the very first slide, now equal to means what? Equal to means A is equal to G. And what about not equal to? Not equal to means A is greater than G and A is less than G. Not equal to means these two conditions, A greater than G as well as A less than G. Fine. Now, are we getting all the three symbols together in one? Yes. Yes or no? Yes. Because the second conclusion indirectly means two different cases. Either A is greater than G or A is less than G. So in the combined form, can I say that I'm getting all the three symbols? Is equal to I got, greater than I got, less than I got. So now here also we are having the either or situation. If we are getting all the three signs, then we are having either or situation. If we are not getting all the three signs, then we don't have either or situation. So here in this case, first and second, we are getting all the three signs together. So we are having a either or case. So the answer would be either C1 or C2. Okay, this is your fourth case. Now case number five says, what you'll do if we have A is greater than or equal to G and A is less than or equal to G. Between A and G, you wanted three signs, so all three signs. So are we getting all the three signs? Yes. Here we are having greater than, here we are having equal to, here we are having less than, and here also we are having equal to. So here also we are having the situation of either or. So the answer is either C1 or C2. Why we are having a situation of either or? Because you are getting all the three symbols together between A and G. those who have selected Hindi language, they can attend those sessions, the first three sessions, either from 7 to 10 or 12 to 3 or 4 to 7. Fine. So this was case number 5, where I'm having all the three symbols together in those two conclusions. Now my question is very simple. Now listen to my question. My question is very simple. What you will do, or can we have any, now listen to my question and then answer me. This is not any case. Now, can we have any conclusion between A and G which can be resulted into true? Answer me this question. Can we have any conclusion between A and G which can be taken as true? No, there is no conclusion where the answer can be taken as true. Why? The simple A and G, between A and G, what do you require? All the three signs. So when we require all the three signs, how can I provide you all the three signs together in one conclusion? Can we do that? No, we can't do that. Fine. So if we can't do that, so how can you say this conclusion is true? No. That means when elements are coming from different sides of LOC, then either their conclusions will be seen as either or their conclusions would be false. There is no scope of any conclusion going to be true. Fine, because why that conclusion can't be true? Because all the three signs can never be together in one conclusion. To provide three signs, they require at least two conclusions. Then we have either or. This is the situation of either or. Okay, so these are the five cases in concept number one. We don't have any other case apart from these five in concept number one. The reason behind is very simple. When to apply concept number one, when we are comparing elements from different sides of LOC, then what is the result? Result is very simple. There is no relation. When there is no relation, how many signs are required? All the three signs are required. And then we have taken all the three signs together in one. Okay. So when we have taken all the three signs together in one, then that is either or. When we are not able to complete all the three signs together in one, then that is false. There is no case of true. So that's all about your first concept. We don't have any other variety or variation apart from these five. Okay, now moving on to concept number two. Let me have concept number two on the board. Now I should write something. Keep on noting this down. When we have to compare elements of the same side of LOC. Okay. Now, whenever we are comparing elements of the same side of LOC, first of all, let me explain this. Suppose my statement is, okay, suppose this is my statement. Now, first of all, tell me from which element or from where my LOC is passing through. Is there any LOC in this statement? Yes or no? And if yes, then from which element my line of control is passing through? Yes, I want an answer. Keep on giving me the answer. Anil Gupta, yes. Abhishek Thakur, yes. Nikita, yes. I'm going through all the answers. Don't worry, people. I'm listening to your responses. I'm going through your responses. Not literally listening to your responses. Listening means I'm going through. Whatever you are writing down on the screen, that's completely visible to me. If you're preparing for a scale 2 and 9, then you can select this batch for Hindi languages. Okay. F, yes, yes, yes. Everyone is correct. We are having line of control passing through F. Okay. We are having a line of control passing through F. Now, my question is, now tell me F belongs to which side? F belongs to the left side or F belongs to the right side? Now, this is my question. Answer me, people. F belongs to which side of line, which side of the statement? The left side of the statement or the right side of the statement? Yes, both. Pramod is saying both. Yes. Both side. Have you ever thought of in your childhood days, you may have seen while playing cricket, we take someone as the common player. So common player have this opportunity of batting from the both sides. Okay, so F is that common player. Depending on the situation, F can go on both sides. Okay, if I'm comparing F with H, suppose I'm comparing F and H, then I will say both are from the same side. In this case, F will be considered from the right side. Okay, suppose I'm comparing A and F. So here also I'll consider A and F coming from the same side. If you are comparing A and E, they are coming from the same side. Okay, so depending on the situation, F can shift its side. Okay, it can either go from the left side or from the right side. Fine. No, the element through which the line of control is passing is not from any side. It can change its location depending on the demand of the conclusion. If the demand says that we have to compare B with F, then they are coming from left side, that is from the same side. Okay. Now moving on. Now read out the line which I have written right now on the board. Concept number two says that when we have to compare elements of the same side of LOC, okay, what I'm trying to say, when we are comparing those elements which are coming from the same side of LOC, then the concept number two comes into picture. Concept number one was for the different sides of LOC. Concept number two was for the same side of LOC. Okay. Now, when we are having elements coming from the same side of LOC, first of all, you need to understand these are the clear signs. Clear signs are less than and equal to only. We should not include equal to sign. Less than or greater than. Less than and greater than, these two are called as the clear signs. Okay. This is not a clear sign. This is not a clear sign. When we are having equal to attached with this, then these are not clear signs. Clear signs are less than or greater than only. Now let me give you the result first. Then we'll cover case by case. Now the result says that whenever we are comparing elements of the same side of LOC, then we require, what we require? Clear sign. So this is my result. I hope you have written down this result. Whenever we are comparing elements of the same side of LOC, then the demand is we wanted clear sign. Fine. Okay, now we'll take them case by case. Okay, what I'll do, I'll slightly change the statement, but we'll cover it up by case by case. So this is my result. What is the result? The result is clearly written here in the box. Whenever we are comparing elements of the same side of LOC, then we require clear sign. Clear sign among whom, between whom, I'll explain everything. Now, case number one, I'll take one by one. Suppose this is my statement. Go through the statement because I'll change the statement slightly. Okay. Now case number one, suppose I need to compare A and F. What do you need to decide first? A and F, they are coming from same side. And when they're coming from same side, what do you require? You require clear sign between them. Now, between A and F, what can be the result? Between A and F, do we have a clear sign? Yes. This is the clear sign. So this sign I'm taking and copying here. So what we can say, A is greater than F. We don't have to go through all the symbols, all the signs. No, we don't at all require that. Whenever we are having a clear sign among elements which are coming from the same side of LOC, then that clear sign can be directly copied. So what I'm doing, I'm copying this clear sign and then I'm taking this result that A is greater than B. Okay, fine. This is my first case. I hope you have understood this and then you are copying this down simultaneously as well. When elements are coming from the same side of LOC, then what we require, I have written down the requirement on the right hand side. A and F, they are coming from the same side. If they are coming from same side, then what we require clear sign between them. At least one clear sign. I don't require clear sign at all the places. At least one clear sign, give me that and then I'll copy that. So you have given me one clear sign, which is adjacent to F, and then I have copied the same sign there. Fine. See, I'm repeating the first case again. Case number one is very simple. Suppose someone wants to understand the relation between A and F. So how can we relate A and F? See the demand. A and F, they are coming from same side. And if they're coming from same side, what we require? We require a clear sign between them, at least a clear sign between them. So between A and F, going from A to F, do we have a clear sign? Yes, we have a clear sign. This one is a clear sign. So I'm copying this. Okay, now I hope if two clear signs are there, I must tell you that those two clear signs are going to be, one question was there coming from Rajesh, that if two clear signs are there, it's very simple to understand. See, if two clear signs are there, going from A to F, simply I am taking this sign. Any sign you can take, any clear sign you can take. Fine. Now we are having case number two. See, suppose we have to compare A and F. Fine. A and F. Do we have any clear sign between A and F? Now think about this. Do we have any clear sign between A and F? Now I have changed the statement. Keep on having a track on the statement as well. I am changing the statements slightly. In the second case, the statement has been changed. Okay. Now what we wanted, A and F, they are coming from the same side, the same analysis. I'm doing that again. Look at the right side. A and F, they are coming from the same side. And if they're coming from the same side, that means what? We wanted clear sign. At least a clear sign between them is required. So now between A and F, do we have going from A to F or going from F to A? Do we have a clear sign anywhere? No, we don't have any clear sign. So copy the sign. What I'm doing, I'm copying the sign because everywhere I'm getting the same sign. I'm simply copying down the sign which is given between A and F. If clear signs are not given, then simply copy the sign. Case one, the conclusion was A was greater than F. Now here the relation between A and F would be A is greater than or equal to F. Fine. Now the result is A greater than or equal to F. Now sometimes what they do, they give conclusion in the form A is greater than or equal to F. So this conclusion will become true. This is true because the same result I'm getting in this statement, A is greater than F is the result. Suppose their conclusion says that A is greater than or equal to F, then this is wrong. Sorry, this is true. Why true? Because we are taking the same result. Okay. Suppose my conclusion says that A is greater than F and A is equal to F. Now I've given you two conclusions. A is greater than F and A is equal to F. Now between A and F, how many symbols are required? How many signs are required? Two, greater than or equal to. Am I getting both these symbols in different conclusions? Yes. So my answer would be either or. I'll say either or. The answer will be either one, C1 or C2. Suppose they can represent the same thing. I am providing you the result as well as the conclusions which they can give you. Suppose they will provide you A is greater than F, then your answer would be false. Okay, why false? Because we wanted two different signs, A greater than or equal to, both. Both signs were the requirement. Fine. So both signs were the requirement and I'm getting only one. That is the reason why this is false. Suppose I'm getting A equal to F. This is also false. These are two different cases I'm dealing with. Okay. So I guess now you must have understood case number two. Simple. If you are not getting the clear sign, then we'll apply the same sign. Now I'll take last case. Case number three under concept number two. We'll talk about one more case. Now case number three. Same A and F I need to compare. So the result is very simple. A and F. See, I'll tell you the entire procedure. A and F coming from same side. Same side means what? Same side means clear sign is required. We want a clear sign between them. So going from A to F, are we getting a clear sign? Going from A to F or coming from F to A, are we getting any clear sign? Yes, we are getting this clear sign. So the result is A is greater than F. Okay. A is greater than F. Simple, simple, simple. No need to be panicked. Now, if you are thinking, can we get any other clear sign? No, we can't get any other clear sign. Reason is very simple. Suppose you want to get this sign, then this sign will create a line of control passing over C and a line of control passing over D. That means now we can say that A and F are coming from different sides in this case. So that clearly means this sign can't be there. Fine. So now you need to understand the essence of the problem. Okay. That's very simple to understand. If they are coming from the same side, what we need? A clear sign between them. Am I getting the clear sign? Yes, I'm getting the clear sign. I'm copying. And then this is my result. So these are the three cases under concept number two. There is no fourth case. You can't even think of any other case apart from those three cases under concept number two. Fine. If you have equal to sign, then you don't have to consider under your discussion. See, suppose someone wants me to consider this. A is greater than equal to B, greater than equal to C, D greater than E, greater than equal to F. Fine. Now, what I told you, replace equal to sine with a comma sign. Getting my point? Now, if I need to replace equal to sign with a comma sign, then see this. What can I write? This A is greater than equal to B, equal to C, then E, and then F. So this means that C and D, they are considered as one single element. They are not different elements. Okay. Okay. Now, if I am comparing A and F, if I'm comparing A and F, then my demand is simple. A and F, they belongs to same side. Same side means a clear sign anywhere between, I'm writing down anywhere between A to F. Okay, so if I'm getting anywhere between A to F, see this, this is not a clear sign, this is not a clear sign, these two are same, this is a clear sign. Am I getting a clear sign? Yes. Now this is your result. A is greater than F. Okay, now let's move on to some questions. First of all, I'll tell you, I'll give you some examples, some basic examples, and then we'll go through the slides. Okay, so let's take some basic examples. Question number one. First of all, I'll provide you one statement. Getting my point? Okay, my statement is A is greater than equal to B. I've given you this statement. I am providing you the conclusions. Now this is my question. Now what you have to do, you have to answer me very quickly. Those who are going through the question, they'll start solving the question. I have given you one statement along with five conclusions. Okay, I'm waiting for your answers. I'm looking for your answers, and then keep on giving me, providing me the answers. Let's take the solution. Now from where this line of control is passing through, first thing is you have to identify, is there any line of control? Yes, there is a line of control which is passing through E. Okay, now if the line of control is passing through E, now tell me what in the first conclusion we are comparing A and E. Now A and E, see this analysis which I'm writing down on the right side, this analysis should be done in your mind. So A and E, they are coming from the same side. If they are coming from the same side, what we require? We require a clear sign. Simple. Fine, no need to complicate things. When A and E, they are coming from the same side, that means what we require? A clear sign between A and E. And now think, is there any clear sign? Yes, look at this sign. So the same sign I'm copying there. So can we say that A is greater than E or E is less than A? Yes, we can say that. So the first conclusion is correct. So the first conclusion is correct. Getting my point? Now, going on to the second conclusion. Conclusion number two is talking about C and G. See, C and G, they are coming from same side or the different side? They are coming from different sides. And when different sides, elements are coming from different sides, that means there is no relation. And when there is no relation, how many signs are required? Three signs are required. Three signs needed. And what are those three signs? Greater than, less than, and equal to. All the three signs are required. Okay. So now conclusion number two, how many signs we are getting in conclusion number two between C and G? We are getting two. One is greater than, one is equal to. Now we wanted a less than also. Now look at the fourth conclusion. The fourth conclusion is also talking about C and G. But see, in the second conclusion, C is greater than G, C is equal to G. In the fourth conclusion, C is again greater than G. We wanted C to be less than G. Don't get confused because of the sign. Getting my point? Sign can bluff you anytime. See, make it a habit that you are reading out the conclusions in your mind. C is greater than G, C is equal to G. And here in the fourth conclusion, C is greater than G again. So we are not having all the three signs. So if we are not having all the three signs, then both these conclusions are false. C2 is also false. C4 is also false. Getting my point? Yes. Now, talking about A and D. Now, what about A and D? I'm taking the third conclusion. A and D, they are coming from the same side. Okay? And if they are coming from the same side, how many signs we require? What we require? What is our requirement? If the elements are coming from the same side, we want a clear sign. Fine. Now, between A and D, are you having a clear sign anywhere between A and D? No, we are not having any clear sign. So what is the result? I'm copying the same sign. So the result is A is greater than or equal to D. Fine. So A is greater than or equal to D. So between A and D, we require two signs, greater than and equal to. Now look at the third case. A is equal to D. Yes, I got one. A is equal to D. Now what I wanted? I wanted A is greater than D as well. But here what is happening in the fifth case? In the fifth conclusion, A is less than D. We wanted A greater than D. What they are giving me? A less than D. That means this is also false and this is also false. So third and fifth, they are also false. So only first conclusion is true. C1 only. Now moving on to the second question. I'm giving you one more question now. Statement. Now keep on writing the questions which I'm providing you on the board. Fine. So statement I have already given. I'm giving you some conclusions now. Okay. Now this is my statement and these are the seven conclusions I have given you on the board. Now tell me, what is the answer? I'm waiting for you people's answer. I'm looking at the board and the responses. Give me the final answer. Don't tell me conclusions one by one. Don't analyze those conclusions one by one. Give me the final and wholesome answer. Now first thing which we need to decide is there any line of control? Yes. The line of control is passing through E. Why we have a line of control? Okay, look at the symbols. The faces of these two symbols are getting closed together in one direction. So we are having a line of control. Now the picture is very clear. Now first conclusion is talking about A and C. See A and C, same side means clear sign. What do we want? We want clear sign. Are we getting clear sign between A and C? Yes, we are having this sign. So the result is A is greater than C. Now if A is greater than C, what is the need of saying A is greater than or equal to C? We wanted A greater than C as our result. You have given me greater than, but apart from greater than, you have given me equal to also. So that means this conclusion number one is wrong. Okay. Now, meanwhile, simultaneously, we can check the fifth conclusion as well, because fifth is also talking about A and C. Okay, so fifth is also talking about A and C. So in the fifth conclusion, the conclusion is saying that A is less than C, but the result is saying A is greater than C. So fifth is also wrong. Okay, so first and fifth, these two conclusions are wrong. Okay. Now the second is talking about G and C. Second is talking about G and C. Now G and C, they are from different side, no relation. And when there is no relation, how many signs are required? Three signs are required. Why I'm repeating this again and again? Because then this thing will be easily engraved in your mind. This can be your practice. Now G and C, there is no relation between G and C, so three signs are required. How many signs we are getting between G and C? G is greater than C. G is equal to C. We are getting two signs in the second conclusion, greater than and equal to. Now, can we have smaller than or less than also? Now, go ahead and check. I'll look at the sixth conclusion. G is less than C. G is greater than or equal to C in the second conclusion. G is less than C in the sixth conclusion. So here we are having either or situation. All the three signs are provided. Okay. Now, third one. Third one is talking about C and E. The third conclusion is talking about C and E. C and E, they are from the same side. They are from the same sign. So a clear sign is required. Are we getting a clear sign? No, we are not getting the clear sign between C and E. So I'm copying the same sign. So the result is C is greater than or equal to E. Now C is equal to E is given in the third conclusion, and there is no other conclusion which is talking about C and E. So we are not getting both the signs. So that means conclusion number three is false. Okay. Now what about F and H? I'm taking them one by one. After this question, I'll do that speedily. So be with me. F and H. F and H, they are from the same side. And when they are from the same side, we require a clear sign. Are we getting a clear sign between F and H going from F to H? No. So what I'll do, I'll copy this sign. I'll use the same sign. So what is the result? The result is F is less than or equal to H. Now F is equal to H is given in the fourth conclusion. And we don't have any other conclusion which is talking about F and H. So fourth is also wrong. Okay. Now we are left with the last one. E and C. Now B on the board. We are seeing that E is there and C is there. They are from the same side. Same side. And then if they're from the same side, a clear sign is required. Are we getting a clear sign between C and E? No. So I'm using the same sign. C is greater than or equal to E. So now C is greater than or equal to E. What do you have given me? C is greater than and equal to E. Yes. Third conclusion and sixth conclusion, they in together, the third and the seventh one. See, C is greater than E, C is equal to E. The third and the seventh conclusion, they will make an either or pair. Why? Because third is saying C equal to E and seventh is saying C is greater than E. So C equal to E and C is greater than E. We got both the signs, but in a different location. So they will go with either or. Third and seventh, why? Because it's clearly between C and E only. Those who are not getting third and seventh, it's very clear. Third is also talking about C and E. Seventh is also talking about C and E. The relation between C and E is C is greater than or equal to E. So C is equal to E and C is greater than E. So we can have an either or. If this is the relation and C is greater than E and C is equal to E, then we have either or, as I told you. Okay. So the final answer would be either 2 or 6 and either 3 or 7. Grimoire point, so this is my second question, and answer for this question is this. Question number three. Take down this question. Now I have given you six conclusions. Okay, now the first thing, what I told you, that whenever we are having equal to sign in this statement, replace that equal to sign with a comma sign. So A is greater than equal to B, B is greater than equal to C, C is greater than equal to D, and D comma E, they are same. This is F and this is G. Now, do we have a line of control? Yes, we do have a line of control. Okay, now what is the relation between A and E? The first conclusion is talking about A and E. So A and E, they are from the same side. We wanted a clear sign. We are not getting the clear sign. So the relation is this. So relation between A and E is A is greater than or equal to E. Fine. So the relation between A and E is A is greater than or equal to E. Fine. Now, conclusion number one is saying that A is greater than E. Okay. Now we wanted A equal to E also. Now, are we getting A equal to E anywhere else in the conclusion? No, we are not getting A equal to E anywhere else. But look at the third conclusion. Now, conclusion number three is saying A is equal to D. This is C1 and this is C3. Okay. Now, E and D, they are same element as we are seeing this. So if I have to replace D with E, can I do that? Yes. We can replace D with E logically. Why? Because D and E, they are the same thing. So now can we say this is either or? Yes, we can say that. You wanted two signs between A and E. You are getting both these signs. This D is nothing but E. I can replace D given in third conclusion with E, and then I can say that these two are equal, and these two are equal, and then they are going with the relation of either or. So C1 and C3, we have either or. Okay. Now, moving on to the second conclusion. Second conclusion is talking about B and G. B and G. Between B and G, there is no relation. No relation. Why no relation? Because of different sides. No relation means all the three signs are required. Fine. All the three signs are required between B and G. Now, what about B and G? B and G, all the three signs are required. How many signs we are getting in the second conclusion? Two. B is less than G. B is equal to G. Now in the last one, B is greater than G also. Look at the last conclusion. So can we say that we have either or situation? Yes. B less than G, B equal to G, and B greater than G. I'm getting all the three relations. So either two or six. What about fourth? Now let's take the fourth. The fourth one is talking about D and F. What is the relation between D and F? D is clearly greater than F. So the fourth conclusion is correct. What about last? C and F. C and F. C and F, they are from the same side. And when C and F, they are from the same side, what do you want? You want clear sign. Are you getting clear sign? Yes, we are getting the clear sign. So this is the relation. C is greater than F. So if C is greater than F, what is the need of saying C is greater than or equal to F? So if we wanted C greater than F, we can't afford to have C greater than or equal to F. So the fifth conclusion is wrong. So the final answer we can say is either C1 or C3 and either C2 or C6 and C4 is correct. So this is my answer. final answer I have written for you people. You can match your answers either C1 or C3 and either C2 or C6 and fourth one is correct. If there is no equal to sign between E and D, then A is equal to D. If there is no equal to sign between E and D, okay, if there is no equal to sign, then A is equal to D. A equal to D, no. A is not equal to D. A is greater than or equal to D. So you can't give only one sign. You needed two signs, greater than also and equal to also. So A is equal to D is wrong. Logically, A is equal to D is wrong here. C1 or C3? C1 or C3? Why C1 or C3? Because let me explain that again. C1 and C3. What is the relation between A and E? Look at the diagram. The relation between A and E, it's very simple. A is greater than or equal to E. Yes or no? And since E and D are same, so we can use D also. Because these two are same. They can be replaced with each other. So when A is greater than or equal to E oblique D is the relation, then can we say that A is greater than E and A equal to D? Yes, we have an either or situation. Why? Because this D can be replaced with E. Getting my point? Because D and E, they are the same thing. They both are different letters, but logically equal to sign is not representing any sign of inequality. Equal to sign is not the sign of inequality. Equal to sign means they are same. They can be considered same. It doesn't matter whether they are different letters or not. If those two letters are equal, then we can logically consider them same. Okay, yes, your replies are visible to me. Don't worry, keep on following me, following my lectures. I'm checking your replies. Yes, bit tricky, Tanmoy, bit tricky, and that is the reason why I'm here. I'm not going to provide you the simple spoon feeding questions, okay? Now, let me increase the bar a little bit. Okay? Now, I'm increasing the bar a little bit, fine? Statement. The statement is, okay, now I'm taking those conclusions now. See this. Is there any line of control? Yes, line of control is passing through D. Is there any other line of control? No, there is no other line of control. Now A and D, same side means clear sign. Very simple. Do we have a clear sign between A and D? No. So what is the relation? If we don't have any clear sign, then copy the sign. The relation is A is greater than or equal to D. So out of A greater than or equal to D, what we are getting? A equal to D. I got one sign. Now I'm searching for, is there any other conclusion which is saying A is greater than D? A is greater than D, yes. Look at the fifth conclusion. Look at the first and fifth conclusion. In combined form, they will create either or. First and fifth in combined form is either or. Because one is saying A equal to D and one is saying A greater than D. So they were creating the condition of either or, fine. Now moving on to the second conclusion. B and G. No relation. Everyone knows what we have to do now. What we have to do when we have no relation, we have to ask for three signs. We have to ask for three signs, greater than, less than, and equal to between B and G. So now B is less than G, B is equal to G. I got two. Is there any other which is saying B is greater than G? B less than G, B equal to G. Look at the seventh conclusion, but this conclusion is saying B less than G again. I'm not getting B greater than G anywhere else. That means second is also false and seventh is also false. Okay, second and seventh, both are false. Now third. Look at the third conclusion. What we are talking about? We are talking about C and H. Different sides of LOC, no relation. No relation means three signs. Okay. So C and H, C less than H, C equal to H. Do we have C greater than H? No. Look at the eighth conclusion. You have provided me C equal to H again. C less than H, C equal to H, and then again C equal to H. So we are not getting all the three signs. Here both are false. The third one and the eighth one, both will become false now. Now, B and M. Now here comes the question. M not present at all. So now suppose I'm asking you to relate B and M where M is not visible in the statement, then how can you relate B and M? So what should be your conclusion? What should be your result? So my result is no relation between B and M. And if there is no relation, that means what? How many signs are required? Three signs are required. Fine. No relation between B and M. No relation between B and M means what? How can we relate B and M when M is not present? So that means we required three signs. So what is happening here? B less than M, B equal to M. And look at the sixth conclusion. B is greater than M. B less than M, B equal to M, and B greater than M. That means we are getting all the three signs. So this is either or. So fourth and sixth will become either or. So now we have checked all the conclusions. And after checking all the conclusions, what is my final answer? The final answer is either C1 or C5. And either C4 or C6. So this is the final answer. So you have to check the option as well. Okay, now I'm taking the next one. That question would be different from the others. Now be aware, this can be a tricky one, literally a tricky one. Now this is my statement. And along with this statement, we have four conclusions. Oh, sorry. Yes, this is not C5, this is C4. The line of control is passing through 3. Fine. Now, but what is out of the box thing in this question? How this question is tricky? Because there is one element which is getting repeated on both the sides. If you're going through that element, which element is that? 2. Element 2 is getting repeated both sides. 2 is there on the left side as well as 2 is there on the right side. Okay. Now, if 2 is there on the left as well as right side, then how can I say that? Now, 1 is great. I'm writing down the statement. Look at the statement. 1 is greater than or equal to 2. Yes. Now there, 2 is greater than 5. Can I say that? Yes. This 2, which is on the left side, and with this 2, which is on the right side, they are same element. Okay. 1 is greater than or equal to 2. 2 is greater than 5. Getting my point? Now, if 2 is greater than 5, then 5 is greater than or equal to what? 4. Fine. Now this is the statement. Yes. What I've done, I have refined this statement. 1 greater than or equal to 2. Fine. And 2 is greater than 5. 5 is greater than or equal to 4. Now, what is the relation between 1 and 4? They are from the same side. What you wanted, clear signs of the relation between 1 and 4 is 1 is greater than 4. And now if 1 is greater than 4, so what is the need of saying 1 is greater than or equal to 4? And what is the need of saying 1 is less than 4? So there is no either or situation between 1 and 3. The first is wrong, the third is wrong. Getting my point? See, if one element, what I'm trying to say, if one element is getting repeated on both the sides, then we can relate those elements in a different way as well. Like I did here in the question, 1 is greater than or equal to 2. I have taken this from the left side. And then the same 2 is present on the right side. So 2 is greater than 5. 5 is greater than or equal to 4. Fine. So what can I say? 1 greater than or equal to 2, 2 greater than 5, and 5 greater than or equal to 4. So now the relation between 1 and 4 is 1 is greater than 4. Simple. 1 is greater than 4. So both first and third conclusion is wrong. Okay, come to second conclusion. Conclusion number 2. Now the same way. What is the relation between 1 and 5? 1 is greater than 5. How can I say this? I can use this clear sign. So 1 is greater than 5. So if 1 is greater than 5, then conclusion number 2 is correct and conclusion number 4 is false. So the answer is only conclusion number 2 is correct. I've given you 3 questions. Those 3 questions are visible on the board. I'm taking the first question. I hope everyone would be able to do this. See, A is greater than equal to L comma T. Why? Because equal to, I'm replacing equal to with a comma sign. R less than H, K. So we are having 2 line of controls. L and T, they are same element, and through L and T, we are having another line of control. So there are 2 line of control. Now conclusion number 1 is talking about H and L. So H and L, going from L to H. Do we have a clear sign? Yes, we have a clear sign. They are from the same side. L and H, they are from the same side. Because through L also this line of control is passing. That is the reason why they are from the same side. So this L is less than H. So L is less than H, this is correct. What about second? K and T. Now K and T, they are from different sides. Same side, they are from different side. Now different side means no relation. No relation means all the 3 signs are required and only 1 we are getting. That is the reason why this is wrong. Okay, so the first question, first correct, second false. Now the second one, is there any line of control? Yes, that line of control is passing through G. Okay, that line of control is passing through G. Now G and P, what is the relation between G and P? This is G and this is P. So is there any clear sign? Yes, I'm copying this. So G is less than P. So G is less than P, first correct. Okay, what is the relation between G and J? G and J, is there any clear sign? Yes. So G is less than J. Second is also correct. Fine. So in question number 2, both the conclusions are correct. Now statement number 3, is there any line of control? Yes, that line of control is passing through I. Fine. Now E and S, they are from different sides. And now if they are from different sides, how many signs are required? 3 signs are required. How many signs we are getting? Only 2. So this is wrong. What about S and N? S and N. See, N and R, they are same. And this is the relation. So n is greater than or equal to s. So n is greater than or equal to s, so second is correct. Okay, question number four. I started getting the answers now. So now what is the relation between y and m? The relation between y and m is completely clearly given. Y is greater than or equal to m. So if y is greater than or equal to m, what is the need of saying y is less than m? So this is wrong. What is the relation between O and S? They are from different sides. And different sides means no relation. Fine, so no relation means three signs are required, only one is given. So both are false. In question number four, both are false. I guess everyone is giving me the correct answer, providing me the correct answer. Now, in question number five, you can go through the conclusions. Now, V and U, what is the relation? See, I'm writing those because they are equal to signs. So don't get confused. V and Z, they are same thing. And then X and U, they are same. So V and U, what is the relation between V and U? V is less than U. So first conclusion is correct. Now, what is the relation between Z and F? Between Z and F, the relation is very clear. Z is greater than, Z is greater than or equal to F. So if Z is greater than or equal to F, going from Z to F, we can go through the same thing. Z is greater than or equal to F. This is wrong. Okay. Next. From directions, from 6 to 10, read out the directions. What you have to do, you have to make it false. R less than or equal to P should be false. Here, what is the relation between R and P? So here in this question, R is less than or equal to P. So this is correct. Why R is less than or equal to P? Because see, this is comma sign. So going from R to P, we don't have any clear sign. So I am copying the sign. Now this is also comma sign. This is also comma sign. So going from R to P, this is R and P. So R is less than equal to P. The same thing is happening here in the second. Now, what about this one? See, there is a line of control. So between P and R, what is the relation? P is greater than or equal to R, or R is less than or equal to P. The same thing is happening here in the third one also. And what about fourth one? See this. From T, there is a line of control. And this line of control will create no relation between R and P. There is no relation. And if there is no relation, then R less than or equal to P would be false. So fourth option is the correct answer. Fine. Moving on to the next question. Here, R, Q less than R should be false. What is the relation between Q and R? Q is less than R. Why? Because there is a clear sign, clearly. So this is not false. Here, line of control is passing through Q. What is the relation between Q and R? Q is greater than R. So if Q is greater than R, Q less than R is false. So this is my response. Because here Q is greater than R, and this is my answer B. And since that's not a multiple choice question, we can directly provide the answer and then move. Okay, now M is greater than R must be definitely true. Here in question number 8, now look at the first option. Here, line of control passing through P. So MR, we can't say because MR, no relation between M and R. In option number B, what is the relation between M and R? Here, M is greater than R. So that should be true. We wanted that. So B option is there. Now, if we are going through C option, in C option also, since there is no line of control in C option, M and R, and we have a clear sign there. So I'm using this clear sign. So M is greater than R. So my answer would be both B and C. As it was given in as the fifth option, both B and C. Getting my point? Okay. Okay, now 9th and 10th. Okay, the statement is clearly given there. Now, from where the line of control is passing, line of control is passing through C. It's clearly visible. My line of control is passing through C. Now, what is the relation between A and D? Between A and D, there is no relation. And if there is no relation, this is wrong. What is the relation between E and C? The relation between E and C is E is greater than C. So this is also wrong. What is the relation between B and D? There is no relation between B and D. So this is also wrong. A and C. Now here A is greater than C. So question number 9, the answer is D. Now here in question number 10. See, their comma means they have given you three different statements. In question number 10, P is less than Q, less than equal to R. R is fine. Now how to relate R and T? How to relate R and T? This is R and greater than equal to T. This is statement number 1. This is statement number 1. This is statement number 2 and this is statement number 3. N is greater than or equal to Q. Fine. Now, definitely true. Which of the following is definitely true? What is the relation between N and R? You can easily connect N and R through Q. Q is less than equal to R and Q is less than equal to N. So that means there is no relation between N and R. So this is wrong. Fine. Got my point. Now what is the relation between P and N? P and N. It's very simple. P is less than Q and Q is less than or equal to N. So P is less than N. So P is less than N. That is my response. And as we are going through the remaining options, it's clearly visible that P is less than N. There's no other option which is talking about some other conclusions. Fine. Now my request is very simple. Don't try to mug up anything. Go through the concepts. Go through the concepts. Nikita is saying explain once more. Okay, let me explain that once more. It's very simple. It's very simple. Don't worry. You don't need to worry. You can create them as a one statement as well. P less than Q, Q less than equal to R. R. Now R is greater than or equal to T. So you can make that this. R is greater than or equal to T. And N is greater than or equal to Q. So N is greater than equal to Q. We can relate them like this. Have you ever studied organic chemistry? Yes, you have studied. So if you want to combine them as a one unit, one statement, we can do that like this. Now connect N and R. What is the relation between N and R? It's very simple. N greater than equal to Q, Q less than equal to R. So there is a line of control. So there is no relation. And if there is no relation, how can we say that N is equal to R? So this is wrong. Getting my point? P and N. What is the relation between P and N? If you want to relate P and N, you have to go through this channel. You have to go through this channel. So P less than Q, Q less than equal to N. So clearly P is less than N. And that is given in the option number B. Okay. Fine. Definitely true means it should be correct. It should be correct. Now, my request is very simple. Go through all the questions properly, analyze them properly. Don't make any silly mistake in the paper. The question paper would be very simple. We are talking about RRB pre. So when we are talking about RRBP, the level of the question paper would be simple. If they want to give some twist and turns to the question paper, they can do that, but it's very rare chance that they will provide some twist. If that paper would be conducted by SBI, then I could have said this thing. Okay, I can say the same thing in IBPS PO as well, but since this is RRB PO and clerk pre-examination, so those questions would be simple and straightforward.
maintain your speed, don't do any silly mistake. Okay, now I am telling you to go sleep, eat, watch, and then don't get tensed about your exam. Your exam would be very easy. We are going to cover the entire topic within those two concepts only, when elements are from different sides or when elements are from the same side.